Apart from an overgrowth of moss, the well looks unremarkable. Dry stones line the wall. At the bottom, something gleams in the dappled light.
Have a lot on my mind. And, well, in it. Just out of view. What's hiding here? Breathe deep and move.
Haste.
To foot. Speak, they burn.
These boots have seen everything.
Thank you.
ready.
Gentlemen,
let's light them up.
As my feet can carry me. Always room for more. Good here, I hope. path lies before me.
Forever dauntless.
Watch and learn.
That's it, dear Josh. Light on my feet. I feel a breeze. I wonder what's down there.
Do this all day.
Maybe it will bring us closer.
Oh. My, you startled me. It's miles away. Not praying. Not quite. I was just practicing an incantation. What can I say? She's Mistra. I can't quite describe it. The need I sometimes feel to see her, to draw the filaments of fantasy into existence. No sculptor or painting could ever do her justice. Only the fabric that she herself is and embodies. The weave. Mistra is all magic. And as far as I'm concerned, she is all creation. Magic is my life. I've been in touch with the weave for as long as I can remember. There's nothing like it. It's like music, poetry, physical beauty, all rolled into one and given expression through the senses. Would you like to experience this? Then follow my lead. Now you.
You feel something strange, like a kind word and a kind touch at the same time. It's warm and comfortable.
Excellent. Now, repeat after me. Athran Mistraril Kantrak Eo.
Suddenly, the scent of rose water and a sense of well-being. A sliver of weave that tastes sweet on the tongue.
Very good. Now, I want you to picture in your mind the concept of harmony, as true as you can.
You see, or is it sense, the presence of a woman? The woman who hovered over Gale's palm. There's something like the anticipation of a kiss, then the pleasure of being cloaked in peace. You are safe. You are nestled in the cup of Mistra's hand.
You did it! You're channeling the weave. How does it feel? That it does.
The weave connects you. The moment feels intimate. You realize the weave is making you one. You have but to imagine your desire, and Gale will know it.
I didn't think.
You perceive quickfire gusts of embarrassment, trepidation, and finally, elation.
Sorry, I wasn't expecting. But it is a pleasant image, to be sure. Most pleasant, in fact. Most welcome.
The weave evaporates. And as it does so, you realize the night feels suddenly cold and lonesome.
Oh, there it goes. How easily things slip away from us, no matter how hard they were in the obtaining. Good night. I enjoyed sharing a moment of magic with you.
Is locked tight with no visible keyhole, only an oval recess in the cover's mouth. You try to examine the book, but the longer you stare, the more those piercing amethyst eyes draw you in. You can sense something dark about this tome, something profane. Irresistible. You feel changed, bettered for having opened it. Suddenly, you are capable of anything. Filling mountains, darkening suns, conversing with the dead. Glyphs shift gently before your eyes. Words slip into your mind, onto your lips, forming words you don't understand. And something is trying to reply. Dart beneath your eyes, warping and twisting. Your head throbs, but you almost understand. The world around you is gone. You can only see those glyphs, only hear those voices. You feel claws moving in the shadows. They pull at you, dragging you closer. The glyphs scream, branding your mind with strange runes. You see time rewritten, fate undone, your future thrumming with power. The book snaps closed. You've seen too much. What profane knowledge is now seared inside of you, you should never have known.